Hello, hello, everybody. It's 5:22 a.m. Central Time on the 4th of November, 2022. It's now Friday morning here in the United States. I've got some breaking news for everybody. If you're on the West Coast of the United States or in the Southwest U.S. or in Mexico and Central America, as you can see rolling by here on the screen, we have a 6.1 earthquake, which was reported in just down south of California's border in the Gulf of California. And I need to turn on a display capture at this point just so you can see what I see ever so slightly better. I'm going to zoom in on the quake. We're also going to go look it up on Google Earth. Now, you may remember, or you may not know, a 6 to 6.1 earthquake struck a day ago out off the coast of California to the west. You can see it here marked in pink. This is right next to where our undersea data cables go from the west coast out to Hawaii. So we were wondering whether or not that was a legitimate earthquake or if it was some kind of other event. Well, I think we have an answer as to whether or not it was some kind of other event. Now, there could be seismic weapons involved, and I don't want to get too hard into that, but those things do exist. But 6.1 down south, this is in an area on the plate boundary. Let me show you down here to the south. USGS is not reporting this earthquake yet. It just struck in the past few minutes. However, you see the red line down here, down to the south. Of course, it goes down to Mexico and it goes up into California. It looks like Ridgecrest has actually just reported an earthquake as well at 3.0 at Ridgecrest all of a sudden. Now, I have a warning going right down here, right down at the border. I warned San Diego down to the border. I'm trying to get it within 200 miles. And we warned you for a 5 to come rolling in here. Now, out in the ocean, you'll notice USGS doesn't have anything marked out there in the ocean. But if you come over and take a look here, what you'll actually see is a fracture zone that goes east and west. West out to Hawaiian Island chain and east, it goes right into Southern California. The fracture zone does. Now, if we go over to Google Earth, we can actually see that the fracture zone makes a bend slightly from here and goes down to the south, down to the east by southeast. And you see the undersea mount chain that actually reflects that goes in and it connects in down to here to a place called Guadalupe, which is a volcanic island, and it goes right into where the earthquake is. So again, you can see we go down into the east by southeast, and the new 6 that just struck down here in Southern California is right next to where we issued the warning. I do need to measure the distance just to see how far off I am. Again, I'm trying to get it down to 200 miles. That's my ultimate goal of earthquake forecasting. And putting the coordinates in on Google Earth will measure up to the border of the United States and just see how far it is. Okay, and again, I have to do this just for my own reference. I'm not putting it down in any kind of ledger book or anything, but I just want to know how far off I am from the border. So if I'm looking for a, you know, noteworthy earthquake to strike in Southern California and then a noteworthy earthquake strikes just south, it's likely the earthquake that we're looking for, especially since it's the exact same size as what struck out in the ocean a day ago. Here's the Salton Buttes. And border with Mexico is right here. Just zoom in and show it to you. Here's the border. We're 365 miles. So I'm trying to get it 200. I'm 160 miles off of my warned area. So that's good. That is likely the earthquake we're looking for Southern California at least. Now, it looks like someone else has weighed in on the quake here. The USGS has now weighed in at 6.2. They've actually brought it in slightly larger. And I would like to go just look at their magnitude list and see how they're coming to that determination. We have body magnitude showing less at 5.5. We'll go down the list and just what we're going to do is we're going to throw out the high end and we'll throw out the low end. And then that'll leave us a good broad swath in the middle of what the earthquake actually is likely is. So just going down the list, it looks like on the high end here, we are going up into the mid-range 6 level. And on the low end, we're going down into the 5 level, maybe even lower. So we're going to throw out the lows and we're going to throw out the highs. And body magnitude now, look how many stations are reporting here. I mean, California's just got a boatload of stations that'll pick things up far away throughout the rest of the state. I think the USGS is probably coming in right, probably 6.1 to 6.2. Like I said, the exact same sized earthquake that struck out in the ocean now is struck over on land, following our general path that we would expect to go. We would expect this to see which way the arrows point, right? So we point over, down, and boom, we go into the plate. Now, this should take us into the southern edge of the craton. I would expect over in Texas very soon to get a fair amount of activity in the next few days, as well as on the edge of the North American craton as a whole, going from the southwest all the way up to the northeast. So if you're in California, I do have some good news for you. First of all, the Southern California earthquake looks like I'm 100 miles off, 160. And it struck, well, I mean, again, pretty far south of the border here. But now look where the rings overlap. Do you see where the rings overlap here? We'll zoom in and show it to you. It's like a oval shape right here, and the arrow is right in the middle. Look where the northern part of that goes. It goes right up to here. Now, this is North LA. There's a bunch of pumping operations that are right there where the rings overlap on the north side. And we go down on the south side, and we go all the way down into another series of volcanoes that aren't even really well known. We go south of LA. We get down next to here, and again, we've got Guadalupe marked up at the surface, but all the other volcanoes that are down here, I don't even see place marks on them. But they're here. I mean, here, let me just zoom in and show you a few. You can see a few outlines of the, you know, the craters and so forth, and the cones, and you wouldn't call those spatter cones, but I mean, these are undersea mounts. But just like on the surface, they build up, and then a magma chamber will fracture somewhere else up above it. But this is just proof that right out here, there's a huge undersea volcanic field when you start to see how many there are. But I don't have a place mark on it. Okay, so we're right next to it, over to the east, over on the plate boundary. So I have to issue somewhat of a new warning for California. Now that the southern part has moved, the northern part has not, and we still have two more warnings going in California. One is up north at Napa Valley, the other is down here at Ridgecrest. And that's why it matters that Ridgecrest just got hit in the past few minutes with a new earthquake. Take a look one more time. On the north side of where both sets of rings overlap, Ridgecrest now is reported in a new 3 or 2.9, 2.8. Edge of the craton should be excited over the next several days. One more time, take a look at this. Going over to Texas, going over to the New Madrid seismic zone, going over to the East Coast. And I do have an update for my Midwestern viewers who are paying attention, or hopefully you're paying attention. I live here in the St. Louis area, just west of the red arrow, and I have a warning going for new swarm activity up to near 4.0 to strike down on the New Madrid, and a warning going in Kansas. Now, both started to move. Kansas got hit at the old oil pumping operations in central Kansas, and now multiple new small earthquakes have broken out on the New Madrid itself. This is matching with the edge of the craton perfectly. And again, even the untrained eye, people who've never seen this before, should be able to match it up that we're going across the edge of the craton. Let me turn off all the numbers. Again, everybody can do a game of the connect the dots from the northwest, down through Idaho, down through Colorado, down to Texas, back up into Oklahoma, back over to the East Coast. This is just 5 to 6 days worth of quakes. Here's 7 if you want to include it all in. It just fills in the areas more for the craton. And this is a huge discovery of mine going back several years, is that there's a flow going across the craton from one direction to the other, going from west to east. Now the plate is moving from east to west at the surface, but down below the earthquakes are going in the opposite direction than the plate is moving. Think of it like a conveyor belt. Or like a log rolling over in a river, where the center of the craton, or a log in a lake rolling over on itself. American Ninja Challenge, where somebody's running across the logs. And the logs are spinning one way or the other. Well, the craton is rotating one way. At the surface, it's going from east to west. But guess what's happening down below? The earthquakes are going west to east, of course. The flow is going the opposite way than the plate is moving. Think of your cell phone vibrating across a surface, right? It's vibrating one way, but the phone's moving the other. I hate to use that analogy. Okay, anyway, back to it. A 6.1 to 6.2 earthquake striking down here on the plate boundary. And the rings are overlapping right on the LA basin now. And we still have two warnings going. One at Ridgecrest, just north by northeast of the LA basin. Let's show you one more time. Right where the rings are overlapping here on the north side, that's Ridgecrest. And then we go out into the ocean, out to the volcanic field. I would look between the two for a new break to take place. But that brings us on to land. Let's go back to the USGS plate boundary map. USGS has it on their feed now, but I would bring it back in right here in North LA on the plate boundary. Now, ironically, that's where the data cables came from. The ones that just got hit the other day. Well, the earthquake that struck next to them, I mean, out here. So the data cables go from right here north of LA and go across and out to Oahu, right to where the 6 is, and beyond. And now the new halfway point is right where the data cables are, coming out from the United States. It's just too weird. Too weird. This is big time movement for the West Coast of the United States, or for the Northeast Pacific, if you want to look at it as Northeast Pacific earthquake activity. We hardly ever get activity out here, out between Hawaii and the United States. It's normally coming in from the Northwest. And over to the east, we hardly ever get 6.0 level activity in Southern California going right down to the south of the border. It's pretty rare, maybe a few times a year at the most. So for it to happen while I'm looking for a 5 to hit here, it's coming in just a little bit bigger than expected down to the south now. It's a pretty big deal. And with what's going on around the rest of the plate, we cannot ignore it that we have a lot of activity taking place right now. And I've been kind of talking about this for the last several days, but when you take a look around and you see on this side of the plate, we're now dealing with multiple sixes. You got to remember, these are sixes, 5.9s, in the middle that fill it in all the way across the entire plate in the last 6 days, or 5 or 6 days. So this is something that I cannot stress enough. It's what we're looking for around the entire West Coast United States and the entire Northeast Pacific. This is taking place right now, what we're looking for. Some other activity has struck, aside from this noteworthy six just south of the border of the United States. Nunavut, Canada got hit. Up here, 4.7 to 5.0 earthquake coming across this way towards Greenland. Also, new 5.4, Reykjanes Ridge. This is out here south of Iceland. And then on the other side, coming out across out of Asia, all of a sudden, new 5.2 earthquake struck in Romania. And this is next to Italy. And we've got our warning going in Italy for the next several days. And that's just the tip of the iceberg. In the West Pacific, we have a series of new deep earthquakes taking place. This is a new deep 5 right on our letter D, which stands for deep earthquakes, of course. So new deep earthquakes in the 5 range tend to be followed by shallower, larger 6s and above, next to the deep quakes and spreading out from the deep quakes. 6s and more 6s. This is, again, the third or fourth one we're talking about in the last few days over here. And it's not something to ignore when we're dealing with California. California, Ridgecrest, California, Napa Valley, do not let your guard down. I hope I'm wrong. Hope it doesn't hit. So far, we're just 160 miles off at this point. And if I'm 160 miles off up in Napa Valley, will it matter? I mean, it'll hit up by Shasta if I'm 160 off to the north, and it'll hit down to the south in Central California if I'm 160 off to the south. Same with Ridgecrest. If I'm 160 off in Ridgecrest, that'll put us like up in Long Valley. Let me show you where we're talking about here. If you don't know California, really quick. So if I warn here at Ridgecrest and I'm 160 miles off, then we're going to be going somewhere right up here by Long Valley or somewhere down here, down at the San Andreas Fault, down in Southern California. Do you see 160 in each direction on top of our 200? And same with up here in Napa. I mean, we're talking about as far north as Eureka and as far south as Monterey Bay going down to Parkfield. So it's not that much of a stretch. There it is. New six just struck. So that kind of settles it for me. Was this a quake or was this sabotage? Could be both. But if that's the case, somebody's got the earthquake weapon. And they already took credit for it. People don't know that Russia took credit for having an earthquake weapon and causing the Japan earthquake. I'm not trying to cause a conspiracy or anything. This is them on their own TV taking credit for it over 10 years ago with a silent weapon, they said. And I'll link that video down below in the description after this video uploads. And if it's premiering over here on YouTube, I will drop it in the chat so you can go watch it yourself. And it's accurate translation. Taking credit for the Japan earthquake back in 2011 and tsunami. And then he goes on further to say the Speaker of their Senate goes on to further say that they have the capability of putting to sleep or putting to rest or sinking, depending on which way you translate that word, sinking or putting to rest whole continents with a silent weapon. And he says no lightning bolts, no lasers, no explosions, that it's a silent weapon that works over time, basically, I think is what he was getting at. And then that gets in with very low frequency and earthquake weapons. But that's crazy, right? Well, you could say they're bluffing, but when we start getting this kind of stuff going on, and it's been 10 years, and it's not really that too sci-fi. So, to going back to where I started, new 6-point-something earthquake just struck down on the plate boundary next to where we just got our 6 coming in from on land. This means we should see our new round of earthquakes break out on the north side, right up here on where the rings are overlapping. That puts us Napa Valley down to Ridgecrest. If we get a third or a fourth, and they come in larger than I'm expecting, this one has come in larger than expected. I was looking for 4.9 to 5, right? Southern California, San Diego, 4.9 to 5. And instead it comes in a magnitude larger. That would be more energy coming in than we were expecting. But with the plate moving the way it is, I'm not too shocked. Again, I'm not too shocked to see that we're going one magnitude higher than expected. Let's hope that just stays over here in the United States area, because if we go one magnitude higher than expected across the rest of the planet, then we're really talking about, I'm going to be making lots of videos this week. And I don't want to have to do that. Although I did just pass a certain threshold on my channel, which I'm very, very excited to report on. You guys can go over and check over on YouTube if you want to see what I'm talking about there. I will record this and put it over on YouTube now as a premiere. Everybody needs to know, new 6 on the West Coast. On top of the other one. Another one just like the other one. The hippies on the West Coast will get that. You guys, much love. I know you live on the West Coast, if you live on the West Coast, I should say. You probably have an earthquake plan, like you've thought about what you're going to do, which, quite frankly, you're way better off than everybody else in the world who doesn't even think about it, but you should probably dust off your emergency kits, because if a 6 or greater hits, if I'm one magnitude under, and we get it up in Napa Valley, that's enough to cause damage. Knock out power. Now, I know it's pretty warm out there in the winter, but you still would want to have the appropriate things you'd need. And, you know, food and water, that sort of thing. I mean, you should already have those sort of supplies on hand. If the past few years didn't teach you about having supplies on hand, I don't know what will. So you should have those kind of supplies on hand. Not trying to lecture you, just make sure you do it. And again, you'll come up with way better ideas for preparation than I'm going to throw out. But, you know, the change of clothes, set of shoes, food, water, batteries, extra ID, extra documents that you need, put them into the bag, the emergency kit, and have it ready to go. And if you don't have to use it after a while, you can just shove it off to the side. But I don't think you're going to have to wait very long on this, guys. Okay, we're already on day 2 of this, day 3, and look at the activity. Be safe, all right? Don't be scared. You need to be prepared. Peace out.